One of the biggest opportunities that developing countries pass by daily, yearly, people, especially women. At the end of the day, it's about one woman. Each woman finding purpose, finding their personal power, and unleashing the potential and possibilities that they all carry. I do believe that women are a treasure trove of possibilities, and the Inspired Women of Worth Network, it's really about encouraging women to live their best lives and not die empty.
I'm here at the iWOW Global Summit 2016.
Today's summit will be brilliant.
Actually, I have my expectation for this event is very high.
The expectation is that we will, you know, a lot of people will find out how to find purpose, how to find possibilities and powers, and they'll be able to go back and apply them to their businesses.
You have taken the time to come out and spend this few hours with us. Learn what you need to learn, share what you need to share, take what you need to take, meet who you need to meet.
The lineup of guest speakers is amazing.
Last year I participated in the event, and this year I'm happy to be here.
And then I expect that after this summit I'll be gingered on to even more greater things than I was last year.
The things and the themes that we will share and talk about will definitely be impactful.
I wouldn't miss this particular event for anything.
Well, it's an opportunity for me to interact with fellow women and rub minds and network.
So the question shouldn't be, why am I here? The question should be, is there anybody who should not be here?
I consider it a great platform and a great opportunity for women.
We're talking about the women of the future.
Women of purpose, women with dreams, women with vision, and women with great goals.
So you can imagine the power, the energy that will be in the room. So I can't wait.
And I'm sure I'm going to have a good time. We are here today to talk to you about how to release that light and let your light shine.
What do you see?
You need to ask yourself that question.
What you see, you become. When you see it, you become it. When you want it enough, you get it.
What am I in the national agenda? You can be an entrepreneur.
In your business, in your life, in your career, what is your full potential?
It's really about knowing your passion, trying to strategize to make your passion profitable.
What were my dreams? Because oftentimes we begin to trade our dreams for reality.
Never stop dreaming. The good, the bad, and the ugly times, that's life. It will happen.
But often in the core, who we are is still there. How can I personify that?
But you need to ensure that your purpose is still there, it's within you. And every opportunity you have, you let go.
Keep moving, keep moving, keep believing, and keep creating.
Find that passion, like find it, dig deep. Think of what you enjoy doing. It may not make sense.
So you have to first start by cultivating your passions and believing.
It may not seem profitable. It may not seem prestigious. It may not even seem realistic.
I love this quote that says, it's not about your resources, it's about your resourcefulness.
So don't think, and we often do sometimes, think of what we do as being menial.
You can make the difference. Why? Because you're coming with purpose, you're coming with a vision, you're coming with passion. Why? Because you found your place.
The humility to know that you don't know everything is critical. And the ability to also know where to go when you need information is very important.
If you have a problem with change, you're going to like irrelevance even less, right?
It's the truth, but nobody will put money into your business if you don't have a value.
I believe that it's possible to survive in an environment and still maintain your values, your core values, who you are.
Somebody can get to a place and decide that in spite of, despite, and notwithstanding, I can take control. This is the iWOW story.
Where you're coming from is not nearly as important as where you are going.
I used to bite my tongue and hold my breath, scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I said quietly, agreed politely.
Whatever you came in here with, I want you to change that picture if it's not positive. I want you to choose the most positive, most empowering picture that you can think of this very minute.
You held me down, but I got up.
But it's all in your hands.
You hear my voice, you hear that sound.
Every one of us has a roar inside of us. But you have a pen in your hands, and you must use your pen to write the end of your own story, your life. You need power. You need to identify purpose. You need to have a clear vision, something that you're looking at. And the vision I want to leave you with this morning is the vision of Nigeria rising because you rose.
It's actually a very good experience, you know, that I had here today.
This is fantabulous. If there's any word like that.
Wow, I would just say wow.
Wow.
It is iWOW.
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 And that's what I can say, wow.
It's really inspirational. That's what I can say.
And it's not like your usual motivational speech, feel good kind of event where you go home and you're like, you've forgotten what you had and what you learned.
And the thing about iWOW as well is that we don't talk to just the career, or the spiritual, or the finance. It's about everything, the holistic woman, if you like.
Kudos to the visioners, kudos to the organizers, every single person on the planning committee. I say thumbs up to you all.
And God bless you.
Because it takes a whole lot to put these things together.
It's about having a tenacity, having resilience.
It takes vision, it takes dexterity, it takes drive, and it takes commitment.
Thank you, Wild Divas, again.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.